defender though. Hazam and Muhammad have been out there now. 40 balls combined. They're on 22 and 20 respectively.
Messages perhaps coming out from the dugout. I'm not quite sure what advice you can give a couple of batsmen who require eight from the last over. It's reasonably straightforward. Get eight. Here's Rick Williams. The man with the imaginary notebook is the one charged with bowling this final over. Here are the misfields. The drop catch from Phillips. They don't come any easier in professional cricket. And then just blind panic out there on the sweeper boundary from the sub Griffiths, and all that means that the home team need eight. Kesrick Williams will do his best to stop it, and I'm guessing there are one or two very high heart rates out in the field there as the Jamaica Tallawahs. Slower ball down the ground. Jason Muhammad jogs through. Well, settling for one.
That in itself is surprising, particularly after the fielding effort in the last over. Jason Muhammad, he should be down there as quickly as possible, turning, looking, potentially putting more pressure on the Tallawahs fielders at the moment. But just the little jog through, there was lack of pressure on the fielders, and if there was a fumble, he probably wouldn't have been able to get back. He obviously wants the strike. He's got it now. What can he do?
20 from 15. One towering hero maximum for Jason Muhammad. Big swing, big miss. Moved nothing but air, Jason Muhammad.
And the reason I think it wasn't given wide was because Muhammad moved across his crease. You can see him there shifting to offside. If he'd stayed where he was, it would have been given a wide.
Bit of sweat appearing on a few brows out there. Just be thankful you're not fielding it long on. Much, much too close for comfort for the home team. Another slower ball. It's up in the air. Who wants it? Powell! Oh, it's almost spectacular! And now Lendell Simmons has booted it 20 yards away. They're coming back for the third, and they get there. Unbelievable.
It all happened right below us. Amazing effort. It was Powell running around. He called it. He said, it's mine, I've got it. He had it all covered. The crowd, they're up. They think it was a six straight away. He knew the boundary was there, the line. He was going over. Lendell, catch it. Oh, but then boot. Let's just kick that away. And they're back for three. Would you believe it?
Extraordinary. The errors that we've seen in the Hero CPL this year. And that pretty much takes the biscuit. It's a brilliant attempt from Rodman Powell. Had the presence of mind to know that he needed to get rid of it. Just a bit too much heat, really, on the handoff. Lendell Simmons rushing in, got a bit too close to it. And then knocked the through ball to the centre forward. Slowly again, down the ground again. Powell, he takes it this time. Hazam goes. Kesrick Williams puts another one in the notebook. There's still work to do to win this game.
The notebook is out. He's been busy this evening, Williams, picking up his second. Babar Azam departs for 23 from 27, 125 for three.
Williams is keeping his cool, showing us his full array of slow deliveries. Babar Azam looking to finish it in style. Picks out perhaps the only man other than Williams who's kept his cool out there, Rodman Powell. Four from two. And how having sort of spluttered into life this game, Melanie. It's given us everything these last two overs.
Roshan Primus now comes out to the middle. He looks reasonably cool and calm, but I'm tipping his heart rate is reasonably high at the moment. 4 from 2 required. This was the wicket again, bowling well back of the crease. The fans didn't read it well, because it was a simple catch to Powell. Oh no, I thought it was going for 6.
Stephen Jacobs wasn't happy about something. Probably saying something about batters, no brains. Well, here we go.
Do we dare say it?
Champagne super over.
Nah.
Williams in. Another slower ball. It's a really good one. It's a really good delivery. Three for a win, 2 for a super over. 1 for the most unlikely victory for the Jamaica Tallawahs, having done everything in their power in the last couple of overs to throw one away.
Well, we have only ever had 1 super over in the 5 years of Caribbean Premier League history. And at the moment, Primus, will he have the opportunity? If he gets 2, they'll go through to a super over. If he can find a boundary, or if we haven't had a 3 tonight. Oh, we have, off the misfield. Yes, the boot. Highly unlikely, you would think, but you never know in this game, that a 3 will come up. So it's a boundary for the win. It's 2 for the super over.
He needs to find the boundary. What is Williams going with long on his back? Deep mid-wicket. No, deep extra cover. Deep point. Third man up inside the circle. Long on. Deep mid-wicket. Kumar Sangakkara inquires, you happy? What do you want? Okay, change that. The wide third man is coming up to a more traditional point. Jonathan Foo is now making his way out to deep backward square leg. We have 2 men protecting the point to third man boundary. And I think Kesrick Williams is ready. The boundary will win it. 3 to win, 2 for a super over. Here we go. Slow ball, it's in the air. Who wants it this time? The substitute fielder is underneath it. He takes it. The Tallawahs have won the game. Kesrick Williams, you absolute beauty. What a final over. The notebook is out again. Eldorado celebrations all over the ground. What an extraordinary finish to a tense and at times turgid affair, but it came to life in the last 2 overs, and boy did it. Kesrick Williams, take a bow.